Last segment on ETBU Extra here today on the ETBU Sportsnet. Thank you for clicking in. Hello, I'm Mike Minkoff along with Jason Soles. In our last segment, we're going to talk Tiger basketball with the head coach of the Tigers, Burt West. Hate to interrupt your lunch, Coach West, here at CC's.
No, you didn't.
Well, Coach, you've had your team on campus for a few weeks. Well, actually, they course checked in August as students, but you've had a chance to do some scrimmages. And as you look forward to your first game Saturday against Millsap, what are you expecting from your Tiger basketball team this year?
I don't know. We had the two practice scrimmage games, and I wish they had counted. We got off to, I thought, a really good start for the season, and so we'll see now that it's really here. See if we're real or not.
Coach, picked to finish seventh, finished sixth last year, first round loss to UTD, who went three rounds deep in the NCAAs. Seven of your top 10 of your rotation from last year are back. Lots of new guys. I just don't see any way this team finishes worse than last year.
Well, I was really wanted to be offended about being picked seventh, but if I looked at the six teams in front of us, I couldn't find anybody to be mad at.
All right. I can give you some names if you want after we're done. Talk a little bit about some of these new guys you got coming in. Anthony Davis, Brett Akins, Chad Herring, they're all new guys that are looking to break into that rotation. What have they brought to the team so far?
Well, Anthony is a small transfer guard. He's a Louisiana kid, Leesville, and he's been playing Mississippi Junior College ball. And he may start. We've got right now a three-man rotation at each position, and so Anthony's doing real well. He's a very highly skilled guard. He's small, but he's skillful. Brett Atkins is a wing player that cut from the same mold as Irby and Dillon, and has a little better skill in one area than one of them, and a little better skill than the other one in the other area, but they're all that's the three-man rotation there. They're doing real well. And Chad is battling to get into that third spot. But those guys are veterans, and Chad's inexperienced. But Chad has shown great promise. Chad's going to be a good player.
Good. Also, we'll talk about a player who, you know, is like a new player to you because he only played in three games, but we know what he brings to the table, Junior Mitchell. Talk a little bit about him, Marshall's own.
Well, I'm so proud of him, and his high school coach is proud of him. Everybody knows he's proud of him. Just talk about just continually improving himself as a player, as an athlete, as a student. He's shown as much improvement as anyone on the team. We're so excited about him. He's quick, he's strong, he's energetic, he's interested, he is all over it. And he and Anthony are pretty good. If I could put those guys together, I'd definitely have maybe the best player in the nation.
Awesome. We talked about the schedule with the women, getting just a few short, quick dress rehearsals before that first conference game. It's even shorter for you guys, just the one game this Saturday against Millsaps, and then Louisiana College maybe move back as well.
Yeah, you mentioned we have seven of our top eight scorers returning, all of our top rebounders returning. It's just such a huge difference to have veteran players on your team. We went over to play our first scrimmage, and the last practice before we got through, and I said, guys, just in case they were to press, we walked through press offense and what to do. They pressed us the entire game, and our kids handled it and just did a really, not perfect, but a really good job. And so that shows veterans, you know, that have seen things before. So that, I think that's the biggest difference. We, excuse me, our two scrimmage games, not going to be a benefit for preparing for the first game or two, but the benefit is that it gave me confidence to see that we can adapt to different things.
Well, Coach West, going into your 22nd season as the Tiger head basketball coach, did I count that right?
No, it's 21.
21, excuse me. I don't want to shortchange you or add years to it. As you head into the first game against Millsaps here at Ornelas at 4 p.m. tip-off, what makes you look at this year's team and go, you know, I'm excited because I can see some great things happening this year for Tiger basketball?
Well, I'm trying to actually hold my expectations down because I always feel that way. I think if things would fall just right, we could be almost perfect. We're just going to – we have a mantra. We're just trying to get better. And we're just day by day. And I reminded them yesterday that they had really played well in the scrimmage last Saturday. Didn't practice quite as well as I was expecting yesterday. And, you know, if we're still thinking about what we did Saturday, we haven't done anything much today. And that's the way we're addressing it. You know, we played well at Millsaps last year, and then we let the game get away at the end. And that's what, you know, I want our team to improve on, finishing games, just improving. We have a better team than we had last year, and the guys are closer. They're more understanding of what we want to do. We've made some changes, and they've picked them up real well. I think they're going to be a real – we move the ball well. I think it's going to be a really fun team to watch. We've just – everybody's got to be on point, and if everybody's on point, we'll be pretty good.
Talk about Irby Thompson and Justin Felicia, their role on your team this year as leaders. Of course, Justin, you know, one of those post players, 8.3 average last year, 6.8 rebounds per game. Irby Thompson, he can hit the three almost at 40% from three-point line last year. What does Irby and Thompson and Justin Felicia do for your team?
Well, one thing, just in the playing part, if the other guys will just watch them, they do the right thing at the right time. Irby has grown as a player. You know, we thought he was a pretty good player last year. I don't know statistically what he's going to do because he's so smart. Now, there were occasions last year that if he had not shot it in a while and he got a pretty good look, he was just going to shoot, you know, and that's the way players do. And he's already demonstrated now, if he doesn't feel it, if he doesn't feel like his feet are under him, because he expects to make every shot. So he has already turned down more shots probably in the first two scrimmages and us playing in practice than he has turned down in 3 years. And that's a real positive. Not that he shot bad shots, but he has just become very selective. And that also shows he has a lot of confidence in his teammates. He doesn't feel the need to, I got to go do something. It's just everybody doing their job. So that's what Irby's doing. He's doing an outstanding job. And Justin, he's better. He's just improved. He's just better in every area.
Looking forward to an exciting basketball season at our Nellis Tigers. Open up the season, 4 p.m. tip-off against Millsaps. Coach Burt West, thank you for your time today on ETBU Extra.
Thank you. I enjoyed it.
Now you go back and finish lunch. Yep, that's right. Well, that's going to wrap it up for today's show.
We got to talk about the fan vote of the week.
Oh, that's right, the fan vote of the week. And I've got it written down somewhere, if I can remember it. This week you were asked to vote on the ETBU fan vote, the best record-setting performance by three Tiger athletes. The three athletes were Tyler Bates, Stephen Alfred, and Josh Warmington. And so this week's fan vote goes to
Stephen Alford.
That's right.
I'm two for two.
With a 63% fan vote. And if you'll like us on Facebook concerning the fan vote, you'll get in for the drawing for a prize to be awarded later from AdvoCare. So look to the website next week for another opportunity for you to fan vote and participate in that. Congratulations, Stephen Alford, voted as the best from the fans, as the best record-setting performance so far this year. Of course, we want to see some more records not only set in the football field,
yes, we do,
but also the basketball, baseball, Tiger, tennis, and so forth. Well, it's been a great show today, Jason. We've had a busy show. Let's get out of here.
All right, let's eat.
All right, let's eat. We've been live from CC's Pizza. Join us again next Wednesday at noon for another edition of ETBU Extra. I want to say thank you to Coach Burt West and Coach Dustin Howard from Tiger Basketball coming by. Also, Jeff Bramlett from the ETBU Tiger Tennis and his daughter, Kate Bramlett, member of the team. Also, Coach Joshua Ergel and Alex Shedder, the offensive lineman. And also, our guest today was Tyler Sellers from the Office of Student Affairs. Don't forget this weekend, Tiger Basketball, 2 and 4 p.m. at Ornell's against Millsap. Mm-hmm. Tiger Football playing 1 p.m. against the University of Mary Harden Baylor. Listen to the football game live on the ETBU Sportsnet at 1 p.m. On behalf of Josh McSwain and Adam Ledyard from ETBU Sports Information, I'm Mike Midkiff along with my partner Jason Soles. So long from CC's Pizza in Marshall, Texas.